I know you mentioned we're now increasing the number of contact tracers that are being hired, no doubt to meet demand. One of the things we're also hearing from schools is that teachers are burning out due to stress, due to, you know, concerns about the virus. Some are staying home, and that's putting an extra pressure on TOCs. Are you worried about teacher burnout and the impact that could have on the education system?
You know, I think we are worried about all essential workers and the challenges that we're facing together around this virus. And we've seen it in healthcare workers. I see it in my colleagues. I see it in teachers, in parents, the anxieties that we have about the effects this is going to have on our community, about long-term impacts. But and teachers are no different. They are dealing with these stresses as well, and we need to support each other to deal with these stresses. Whether you're a healthcare worker, a surgeon who's trying to catch up on people who have had their surgeries delayed, whether you're working in a long-term care home where the intensity of the concern about the virus getting into a long-term care home, whether you're somebody who's working in one of our food processing plants or in a grocery store with the essential services that keep our communities going. We are all facing these stresses, and we all need to support each other. And how we do that best is by following the important things that keep us all safe. And right now, we need to focus on reducing our social contacts, making sure that we are taking all of those measures to keep this virus from being transmitted in our community. And that's what's going to support all of us.